Hello students, yesterday we were studying the important topics regarding to the chapter wave optics, and there we have already studied a number of important topics that can be asked in your examination, and that are actually in the point of view of your examinations, that are very important questions, and you have to understand their conceptual problem, their derivatives, or all the ways or numericals are based on that conceptual question based on it, that all are important here. So here first today let's discuss the topic, that is Young's double slit experiment. So as yesterday we have discussed interference of light, and also what are the conditions that are necessary for the interference of light in the to get the well defined or sustainable interference, and also there we have seen that how the intensity is distributed after the interference of the light from the two coherent sources. So if sources are coherent, then an interfering term that is appear in the case of intensity, and that we have seen that that is dependent on the phase difference between that two waves. If phase difference is maximum, then we are getting maximum intensity, and phase difference is minimum, then we are getting minimum intensity. So according to that, even we have derived a formula for the path difference in terms of the wavelength, that is for that are the conditions of the maxima and minima. Means for maxima we have a condition, that is the path difference will be even multiple of lambda by 2, and for minima we have odd multiple of lambda by 2. So this is the concept with using it. Young's performed an experiment on this, and let's see what is this experiment and how can you define or how can you calculate or understand the position of maxima and minima on the screen due to interference of two waves, and the two light sources that we are using here that are coherent in nature. So whenever there is interference between them, then at some distance, if you want to know, suppose that we want to know that at that point whether there will be minima or maxima. So how can you understand that? This experiment tells us that. So for this experiment, first of all, let's see what is the arrangement here. So here we have taken first of all a light source S, and through which light is traveling in all direction, and here the division of wavefront method we will use to produce coherent sources, like I have already discussed it. So if division of methods we are using, so here suppose this source S, we have splitted this source into two light sources or two slit. You can see that here, suppose this is source S1, this is a source S2 here. Clear? So due to, with the help of the wavefront and division of wavefront techniques, we have divided this one light source into two light sources, and obviously these two light sources are at the same time we have taken it, they are also in the same phase, so they are automatically coherent. So coherent property we have got here. Now suppose here we have just placed a screen here to observe the interference due to these lights. So here suppose this is two slits we have. Now the light obviously after passing to the slit, light will travel further. So due to traveling light, suppose at this point one of the wave due to these S1 and S2 source that gets interfere at point P on the screen. So these are the lights. This is the basic diagram. With the help of that, you can understand there are this number at number of points the waves from S1 and S2 can interfere, but still for our study we are taking only one wave from S1 and one wave from S2 that is interfering at point P. So suppose at P they are superimposing over each other, and this is the point of central point. Clear? So suppose if the distance between these two light sources, that is, or these two slits, that is small d, the distance between source and screen, that is capital D, this can be measured easily. And now let's see here, this is the center point, and obviously at central point, if the light will reach here, then the time taken to reach at this point, suppose this is point O. So at point O, if the light will reach from S1 and S2, they will take same time and they have to travel the same distance. So that's why the light waves that are reaching here, they will be always in the same phase. So due to their interference, there will be no interference or uniform illumination we will get here. So there is no condition of maxima or minima we will get, because there is no phase difference between these two waves. These two waves are as they have same phase, they are alike waves. So that's why if they will interfere, they will give us uniform illumination here. Means at O we will always get bright point, will always get maxima here. So this point has been decided. Now we want to see that, suppose here the distance of this point P from O, that is small y, and we want to calculate that from this center O, at y distance, if this point P is situated, so at this P, if wave are interfering, then whether this point P is of maximum intensity or minimum intensity, means if whether there will be maxima or minima, if we want to know that, then how can we know it? Or what are the conditions to get here maxima or to get here minima? So let's see them. First of all, we have already one condition that we have derived, that is if phase difference between two interfering wave or path difference between, actually let us suppose path difference only. So path difference between two interfering wave, that is even multiple of lambda by 2, then at this point we will get maximum intensity, and if it is odd multiple of lambda by 2, then we will get minimum intensity. So we will use this condition for the determination of the condition for this point to be maxima or minima. So for the calculation, what we need, first of all, here we need the path difference between the two interfering wave. So here if you see the path difference, then obviously the here the distance traveled by this wave from S2, that is S2P, and from here S1P. So obviously the path difference will be S2P minus S1P. Extra path that is traveled by it, you can take it by simple its difference. So path difference, that is equal to S2P minus S1P. Now let's see this figure. And here, just match this here like this, and also this one like this. Clear? So if you match this like this, then you can see that here, this S1P, you can calculate it very easily. So what will be the S1P and what will be S2P here, we can see easily, and even we can calculate it very easily. So as here this distance is small d, this is capital D, this is our y. So at this distance, this is half distance, this is y by 2, and also you can understand easily it, what is the distance of here. So with the help of that, if you use Pythagoras theorem, then you can see that what is the distance of S to P here. So distance of, actually this distance is just here to here distance. If you can see, this is whole, this is B distance, as we have the distance between two slits, and this is the distance between two slit here, and also this distance is what, this will be D by 2. So if this is D by 2, and obviously this distance, this is Y, this is D by 2, then this will be Y minus D by 2. So if you put here some word m, here also m, so the distance PM, that is equal to y minus t by 2. So let us first of all, let us see what is S2P, after that we will see what is S1P. So S2P, this distance you can see with the triangle S2PN. So in triangle S2PN, if you use Pythagoras theorem, then with the help of that we can write this S2P square, this is equal to S2 square plus PN square clear. This hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square upon base square. So here the value of S2N that we have, that is B square here. The value of PN. So let's see again what is PN. Here this distance is y, this distance is t by 2. So overall distance that will be y plus b by 2. This is of whole square. In the same manner you can see what is the distance s1p. Here we have. So then again s1p square will be equal to s1m square plus pm square. So s1m square plus Pm square. So value of S1m is again equal to this distance d. So this is d square. This distance Pm is equal to, we have this y minus d by 2 whole square. So as this is y, this is d by 2, then this will be y minus d by 2. So finally we have got here what is the distance s2p, what is distance s1p. Now you can calculate easily what is path difference, and after calculation we can use the condition for maxima and minima easily. So just erase it. So finally we have s2p square, s1p square. What's the difference of them? Then the value of s2p square we have, that is d square plus y plus d by 2 whole square, minus the value of s1p square we have d square plus y minus d by 2 whole square. So this we have got after the geometry of the Young-Stubber-Slit experiment. Now you can easily calculate it. Now let's solve it. After solution you can see here this d square will be cancelled out by this d square, and let's expand this whole term. Then this will be y square plus d square by 4 plus 2 times y into d by 2. Then finally you can get here y into d. So and minus d square is already cancelled out. Then let's see it. This will be y square minus d square by 4 plus y into d. Only use the whole square formula here. And after that, this term will be cancelled out. This will be cancelled out here. So finally, we will get here 2yd after the solution. And now you can also expand these terms in two terms, as this is a square minus b square formula. So we can write here s2p minus s1p into s2p plus s1p. So finally if you will see that s2p minus s1p, so this value will be equal to 2yd upon s2p plus s1p. And if you see in the diagram s2p plus s1p, so this value is nearly equal to 2 times the distance between the screen. So you can use this. So after using this we will get yd upon 2d. So after solution this will be yd by d. So this is final term that we have got after solution. Is this is the path difference between two light waves that are emerging from two coherent sources S1 and S2, and they are interfering at point P. Then due to their path, a path difference has been created. This path difference is equal to yd by d. Y is the distance from that point P from the center maxima. D is distance between two sources, and this d is distance between source and screen. So on these terms, in the form of these terms, we can get the path difference here. Now let's apply the condition of maxima and minima, and after that you will get the condition for the to get maximum intensity at point P and condition to get minimum intensity at point P. So this we have got here. Now for first of all, for constructive interference, or you can also write here for the maxima or for bright fringes, whatever you want to write, you can write it here. So for constructive interference, we know that already from the discussion or explanation that we have done for the interference of light yesterday, that the for the maximum intensity or for constructive interference, this path difference, that should be integral multiple of lambda by 2. It means that you can write 2n into lambda by 2, or directly n lambda you can also write here. Now let's put the value of y. This is yd by d. This is n lambda. Or after solving it, y is equal to n lambda capital D upon small d. So you can put here yn also. So here we are seeing that this lambda, this is, as we are using monochromatic light source, then definitely for monochromatic light source the wavelength will be constant value, and also d is this distance between source and screen, that is also constant. Small d is distance between two sources that we are using for the interference, so this is also constant. So here only on the factor in on which this is depending on, that is n. So n can have the value, integral values, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, it's the value can it have, and it is known as the order of the fringe. For n is equal to 1, we are getting first fringe, or we are calling it first order fringe here. The center point that we have got, point O, that was of maximum intensity, that is called central maxima point, not the first order maxima point first of all. So this is central maxima point, and behind, beyond these central maxima on both sides, we are getting alternate maxima minima. So that is first order maxima, first order minima, first and second order maxima, second order minima. So in that way we are getting, so for n is equal to 1, this is first order minima or maxima, for n is equal to 2, for second order maxima here. So in this way you can understand, if P point you are changing randomly, then with change in P point, the order of the maxima or minima, that will change, and accordingly, if this, suppose that here n is equal to 2, then that at that P point we will get second order maxima. For n is equal to 1, we will get first order maxima or first maxima that is obtained in the system. For n is equal to 4, we will get fourth order maxima, means fourth maximum point we will get there. So if you will vary P point, then according to that, the order of interference pattern, that will change also here. So I think the condition for maxima or bright fringes, that is clear. So this is the condition for maxima or bright fringes. Whenever y or p point is at the distance of integral multiple of lambda d by d, then that time, that point p will be of maximum intensity always. Clear? Now let's see what is the condition for the destructive interference here. Condition for destructive interference. So for destructive interference or for dark fringes or minima, we have a condition for the path difference, that is, if the path difference between two light waves that are interfering, that will be even odd multiple of lambda by 2, then that time we will get minimum intensity. So for that, delta should be some 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. This is odd multiple of lambda by 2 here we are getting. And now let's put the value of delta here. So this is yd by d. This is equal to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. So after solving it, we will get yn, that is equal to 2n minus 1 lambda d by 2d. So as here we are seeing that this is the condition for the minima at point P, means whenever there will be odd multiple of lambda d by 2d, then that time we will get at that point P the minimum intensity or dark fringes. So if this situation is followed, then we will get different dark fringes here. Like for n is equal to 1, we will get first dark fringe. For n is equal to 2, we will get second dark fringe, and that is known as second order minima, first order minima, third order minima, and so on. So in this way, we are getting a number of minimas. And means if point P you are varying and you want to see that if that point P is of minimum intensity, so if that point P is satisfying these condition, then obviously that will be of minimum intensity. Or in other word, simple, if you want to know what is that point P is minima or maxima, so just calculate the distance of that point P from the central bright fringes first of all. So after central maxima, if you calculate this distance y, so if that distance is even multiple of lambda d by 2d, then that time that will be of maximum intensity. And if it is odd multiple of lambda d by 2d, then that time it will be of minimum intensity. So according to this condition, you can easily understand whether the point P is of dark fringes or bright fringes, and what is the distance. If you know that already this is point of bright fringes, then what will be the distance. So from this formula you can easily calculate it without any other calculation. So this allow us to understand in better way to explain or understand the concept of interference fringes. So Young's double slit method is very efficient method to know about the interference fringes, and this method is based on the division of wave front method. Huygens principle helps here a lot to understand the concept of the interference here. So I think the concept is clear. So if this concept is clear, then let's see what is the fringe width we have. Fringe width means, as we are seeing that there are bands for the say bright or dark fringes, like if such types of bands we are getting. So as here in this band we are getting that this is some thickness here, or between two consecutive, suppose that here between these two points, what is the distance between two dark fringes, or what is the distance between two bright fringes, that is also known as its fringe width. So you can calculate it easily. Suppose here we already know, first of all, if you want to suppose something, then let's suppose that this is first order maxima and this is second order maxima, or this is first order minima, this is second order minima. So for first order maxima, what will be the condition we have? So we have already a condition for the distance. Suppose at point P we are getting the first order minima, or at point P we are getting second order minima, then what is the condition for the distance to at which we can get it? So yn is equal to, we have n lambda d by d, this condition we have. So let's use it. So for first order minima, maxima, we have y1, its value is 1, obviously value of n is 1, lambda d by small d. And for second order maxima, y2, then this value will be 2 lambda d by d. Now what is fringe width? So fringe width will be simply the difference between these two distance. So y2 minus y1. So if you calculate this distance, then this will be simple. Take the difference here, 2 lambda d by d minus lambda d by d here. Finally, we will get lambda d by d. So this is the fringe width of the maximum intensity or bright fringes. So distance between two bright fringes or fringe width is equal to lambda d by d. Using it, you can calculate that what is the spacing between two bright fringes, or what is the width of bright fringes in our interference pattern. In the same manner, you can also calculate what is fringe width for dark fringes. So let's calculate it also. So again here suppose that for dark fringes we have first order dark fringe and second order dark. You can take any of the dark fringe to calculate it. The result will be same lambda d by d. You can take second, third, but at least you have to take two consecutive dark fringes. You can take yn, yn plus 1 dark fringe. So you can take in that manner also. So as it is dependent on you, I am taking only for the simplification first and second dark fringes or bright fringes here. So for dark fringes we have condition that is 2n minus 1 lambda d upon 2d. Now for the first dark fringe we have y1 is equal to, put the value of n is equal to 1 here. So if you put here, then this will be 2n minus 1 means 2 minus 1. So finally we will get lambda d upon 2d here. And for second dark fringe we will get here, put the value of n is equal to 2 here. So here that will be finally 4. 4 minus 1, this is 3 lambda d by 2d. And now let's take the difference between these two, and this will provide us the distance between two dark fringes or fringe width for the dark fringes. So this is beta is equal to, again let's take it, suppose this is beta of dark fringes. So this is equal to y2 minus y1, or put the value of y2 here, this is equal to 2d minus lambda d upon 2d. So after solving it you will get lambda d by, here also capital D will be, so this is capital D, so lambda d by small d here. So as we are seeing that this is the same value as we have got for the bright fringes or fringe width for the bright fringes. So simple meaning is that it means in interference pattern for the Young's double slit experiment, all the fringes will be equally spaced, whether it is dark fringes or white fringes, and its distance is or fringe width is lambda d by small d. So if you will draw these fringes, then that should be something like this. If this is this, then this distance between them should be also, spacing will be equal here. So as we are seeing that the fringe width equal, they are equal here. So such types of fringes we are getting in case of Young's double slit experiment, in which all the fringes are equally displayed, equally spaced in the on the screen, and also the distance between them is equal, that is equal to lambda d by t. So you can calculate it by putting the value of lambda capital D or small d. So what is the so of the these bright or dark fringes here? So if so as we have discussed today what is Young's double slit experiment and how can you calculate at any point that is the point of maxima and minima, and if that point is maxima, then what will be the distance of that maximum point from the central bright fringe, and what is the distance of the minimum point from the central bright fringe. With the help of that we are now able to calculate or understand the position of maxima minima, or the pattern that we are getting, the information about that we can understand easily. So interference patterns helps us to know about the even the properties of the superposition of waves and these all things. So here we have just discussed the interference topic, and in the case of interference topic, first of all we are needed some of the things, that is the same amplitude, same frequency. Amplitude can be different, but still we have discussed that if amplitudes are same, then that time the interference pattern that we'll get, that will be more sustainable, more suitable. So that's why we will get the same, we will take same amplitude. And here exactly we are dividing one source into two source, then definitely the amplitude of that wave will be automatically same. And after their division, they will be coherent wave. And after getting the coherency, if two waves are going to superimposed over each other, or if they are interfering, then definitely they will provide us interference pattern. And if that interference pattern we are getting, you can understand easily it by Young's double slit experiment, what is its position of maximum minimum. So the topic that was important regarding to the interference pattern that we have discussed. So next day we will discuss the topic of diffraction here. So let's end the class here today. Thank you.